everyone. I'm Anupama Chopra.
Hi, guys. Hi.
And there's my wonderful colleague, Bharadwaj Rangan, wearing bright blue to sort of infuse some energy into this conversation.
I think there are some flowers and all in this. So
well done.
Paddy and I have been sort of going back and forth on this whole OTT versus theaters conversation, which is just becoming more and more heated. And, you know, there seems to be all sorts of kind of back and forth between producers, between multiplex owners. So what is your take? You know, of course, there's major Tamil films going to Amazon. There's major Hindi films going. How are you all feeling about it?
Well, I have lots to think about. I think I can write a PhD. It's all that we've been thinking for the last 2 months, actually.
And Shafi has a really big film coming up. I mean, like a really big film. So
yeah, long term, I think this, whatever's happening during this time, I think is good for the industry, because I think there's going to be a certain polarization in terms of the kind of content that will find the right place for its consumption. I think this is something that the entire fraternity was prepping itself towards. It should have happened in the next 2 years or 5 years, where the big tentpole, star-driven event films that are going to find theaters as their first preference to, you know, engage the larger audience and have that kind of experience, versus these small niche content-driven films that you know is not going to get the audience out of their homes, into the car, through the traffic, buy the, you know, parking ticket, and then watch that. So there's going to be a kind of polarization in terms of the kind of content. And I think it's also going to, you see a stark difference in the demography of the audience that are going to watch it. So I think post-COVID, with a combination of the economic conditions, psychological reasons, you know, there are so many things that's going to affect the audience, right? And they'll need the right reasons to go into the theater. So I think the star-driven, so it's going to be good content. Again, it's not going to be just brainless cinema. I think it's going to be good content by great performance and a big scale film is what is going to drive the audience. I think in the long term, that's a good thing for the industry, actually.
But right now, are you saying that sitting on big films that without knowing that there is going to be a release date in the near future, or without knowing when the dates are going to be possible, is that a financially viable proposition? Because Shashi, you have a Dhanush film coming up with Karthik Subbaraj's direction. So what do you guys think about that aspect of it? That is the immediate future.
Yeah, that's what I think. We need to divide the conversation into the long-term effects of what's happening right now and what's going to be the change that you're going to see a year and a half from now, versus what you're going to see in the next 6 months to a year. I think a lot of this is going to be a sequence of things that's going to be driven because of the economic conditions of various, you know, stakeholders in the chain. I think the ones who will be able to hold on to the content, thinking that eventually when the theaters release, they'll have a much bigger crowd, will hold on to it. If there is pressure in terms of returning the money, borrowing, all the stuff, and they think OTT is going to be... So it's not a qualitative issue right now. It's not what I was talking long term is a very qualitative kind of thing. But here, I think this would be more in terms of survival. I think people will be, most of the decision making will be based on survival. Are you going to survive this phase to be in the industry, right? So we can't take everything because, you know, there is a certain sequence of thinking behind it. But I think it will be driven more in terms of, will I be the sort who can like hold on to my content and see through this phase and then release it later. So I think that's how you'll have to look at it. I think this is, you know, there's going to be pressure. Even OTT platforms will require, if you look at it already, after 2 months of being in this lockdown situation, there's not enough content. You realize that everybody exhausts things very quickly. So, and you will have a situation that none of the productions are going to go into flow, and their pipeline is going to be cut. Where are the theatrical releases for the OTT platforms to, you know, plug in their digital, you know, releases? So, there's going to be a bit of, you know, shifting in terms of where OTT needs to go after this market. Even before they release, they need to go after it. So there's going to be, you know, pull and push from both ends, I think.
Yeah.
Shashi, would you agree with that? That in Tamil cinema, it would work the same way, that the producer would kind of take a call and then have a discussion with the actors and the director and things like that?
I would think so, because I don't think, I mean, we're doing three films right now, and there are two small films that's something that, you know, I might have like a, you know, complete power in terms of making the decision. But if you're working with a big director and a, you know, a big star, you obviously have to, you know that, you know, the minute I tweet something about this particular meeting, Dhanush's fans are asking about when is the update for the release, update for the release. You would have seen all this unnecessary, you know. So everything, so the kind of pressure that is there on a producer just to even update, forget about release. If I even breathe saying that I'm going to go OTT, you know, there'll be guys outside my house asking, why are you doing this? So obviously, that's what I meant, that all the stakeholders have to be on board for a big film. Obviously, it's a big thing. I mean, the director and the actor also, you know, give away a year of their life, you know, and the stars have to cater to their large audience as well. So there is, obviously, we'll have to take all of them into consideration before taking that call.
So when you talk about a big film, Shashi, it's you mean like a big budget film, right?
A big star film, more importantly, a big star, because, you know, you are obviously, you got him in because of his audience. And then if you're divert, I mean, his audience are in the theater. So then you decide to, you know, hijack that and put it into a different platform where the audience is still evolving. Obviously, it warrants a conversation at the least, right? I mean, I don't think you would have just called up and done it, say, it's coming out on OTT. That's not going to, you know, work. So I think, I mean, obviously, we have a very friendly relationship with Dhanush and, you know, Karthik. It's much easier to have that. But I would assume otherwise, it would be a difficult conversation. I mean, if the Vijay's film, which is, you know, supposed to release 3 weeks before us, I think there's a large debate that's going on. We're hearing things that you know, that's there for the taking as well, or whatever. There's obvious conversations that are going on.
You just brought up the topic of audience, Shashi. There is one section of the audience that has already had access to OTT. There was one section of the audience that is right now during this phase has kind of gotten acclimatized to OTT. And there is probably, there's a large section that is not, that's, if that audience sees the movies, it'll only be in theaters. So when we are talking about selling a movie, let's take Gulabo Sitapa, because that is an established fact now. When we're talking about something like that going to OTT, is it going to ever reach the audiences in smaller towns and places where there is no OTT penetration at all? Or am I mistaking where OTT has penetrated and it's everywhere?
Well, and also to your point, Barry, the concept of procurement for, say, a theatrical release versus an OTT is completely different. You know, you have a very specific date of release, date when it's going to go off the theaters, and it's a very dated kind of conversation that you're going to have. There is a specific window that an audience are going to see it, and then if you're going to gauge by that, versus an OTT that's never going to get dated. So the acquisition is not based on what can I do for the next 2 weeks. It could be for the next 5 years, 10 years. Acquisition is not only for the film, but it's also, if, for example, if any of the big OTT platforms wants to make a major move into a regional market, say, I would think that picking up a big film is the best way to do it, because you're going to drive new audience into the into the platform. So, you know, I see there is a reason why an OTT platform would go after bigger films rather than the smaller films now, because it also increases subscription base for them. And that's a long-term, you know, money earner for them rather than just the one film kind of thing. Imagine a big star film going and suddenly you have like 30 lakh, 40 lakh new subscribers in Tamil Nadu. You're garnering close to 200, 300 crores. That sets them up for the next 4-5 years, right? So I think the dynamics of how money and audience work is completely different on an OTT platform. And there's reason why the OTT needs to go after the... There is a, you know, if the OTT decides to go into the market right now with big money, you can see a paradigm shift in terms of the entire structure of how, you know, movies are consumed. But I think it's not going to be the case. But, you know, I can see how, if I had 1,000 crores, I would move into the market and just take it over now. And you will collapse the system for another 1 year that there's no movies to be consumed except in your OTT platform, right? So there's a difference between acquisition of a content, say, from a theatrical distributor versus an OTT platform kind of person, actually.
So, guys, we got some questions in from our viewers. Sajid Ali asks on Instagram, would movies have to be differently cut for OTT? Would movies still have the same dance sequences, interval, hero entry shot, all the elements which are so enjoyable in a theater, because in a in an OTT that experience is completely gone.
Tashi, you should take this question, because the format is very, very big to us, right, in the terms of whatever was discussed in that question.
See, there again, I think there is a specificity to how people watch stuff on OTT versus a closed environment where you already, you know, you're bought into the idea of watching it for 2.5 hours. There's a lock-in period when you have in a theatrical thing. So it's left to your discretion to figure it out in terms of, you know, whether I would have comedy, this, that, whatever's entertaining. At the end of the day, people will watch if it's entertaining and they will leave if it's not, right? But you, if you look at the mantra of most OTT platforms, they tell you that a person can switch off in the first minute, second minute, third minute. Every minute of the show is, you're liable to be switched off, right? Because, you know, it's in his convenience that he can, you know, it's not a guarantee that somebody who watches the first 5 minutes or 10 minutes of the film is going to go on and finish the film, right? Because he is willing to put his eggs in another basket as well. So you got to be sharper. I think your attention span in an OTT platform is going to be sharp. You know, you're not, so there's all the bits and pieces which are okay for a theatrical bits. I think you will be sharper. You will not, you know, take the chance saying that, listen, this might work for the C-class audience, so we'll have this content. So there's a lot of mix that happens for a theatrical kind of film, right? The conversation happens, you know, we'll have some bit of here. So I think, you know, again, this is a long shot. I think we've not had case scenarios where there are, you know, feature films that are original features that have been made directly to OTT to still, you know, get the point across. But I think the time is also going to come. I think along with this churn, I think you will see that the OTT platforms will shift to trying to figure out their original features, which is something then we'll have a better answer. But I think it'll be very specific to OTT platforms. I think OTT platforms eventually becomes the super producers, like the studios of the olden times, right? So producers will work for the big studios. And I think those things are, I think you will have pure filmmakers who will say, don't even touch a second of my thing. This is the final cut. You can't do anything about it. And there will be people who will collaborate with you and try and figure it out. So I think those kind of conversations have always been there, whether it's OTT platform or theatrical release, your director will sit next to you and say, this is what I want, actually. So I think it's good. I think it's good.
I have one last question. Sachin on Instagram says, how different is the marketing of a film that goes on OTT going to be versus a film that goes into theater? You know, how does this, the marketing landscape change because of film's distribution changes?
Well, that's the million-dollar question with all the OTT platforms right now, which is what the experimentation is going on. So for the first time in a long time, we saw a full page ad of the front of the dailies in Tamil cinema when the Jyotika film released, which is banned by the producer council because, you know, you're not allowed to spend that kind of money on publicity. So, you know, the norms are going to be challenged. And I think people are going to find ways to get into it. I mean, I think there was more money put into the campaign than a normal theatrical release would have had. The sheer, you know, the spread of the campaign was very visible, actually. So deep pockets means deep, you know, different ways to get to your target audience. And it's a virgin landscape for people to go out and get there. It's not just the movie. It's also buy into their platforms, right? So you cannot take the spend as it's part of the customer acquisition cost right now. So you'll have to look at it as not just marketing, but it's also a, you know, acquisition cost for the OTT platforms.
So actually the viewer gains either way.
Absolutely. I think that's the best thing about this is that content consumption is going to be more specific. I mean, there was a difference. See, there's a restaurant giving you home delivery is different from Swiggy coming on an app and doing this. There's a specificity to how that same content is consumed at your place. There's the delivery mechanism is different. You're in their ecosystem. They're able to, you know, bring you in whenever they want. So the efficiency of the delivery of the OTT platforms is what is going to change the landscape. It's just not, we've always had, you know, ways of bringing content into our homes, but the efficiency at which it's going to be delivered is what is going to change, not anything else.
Well, sounds exciting and interesting. These are interesting times, Barry. Anything, any more questions from your end?
No, I'm just like dazed actually right now, because I'm unable to make up my mind whether it's a good thing or a bad thing. Because yes, as Shashi says, in terms of sheer consumption, I think it's good that the audience has a choice. But I'm also like, when we're talking about, you know, the very few auteurs that we have, the filmmakers who structure their films in a certain way, and all that, if somebody's watching those films at a 1.5 speed, or you know, deciding to take a break at a thing, I'm feeling that cinema will become less like cinema and more like something you just consume. I mean, I don't want to make it sound very like lofty, but you know what I'm trying to say, right? It's going to be very different from watching a very specific director's quirks on a big screen where you're stuck, versus somebody saying the scene is boring, let's fast forward through it and go through the next one. So it's going to change a lot of things, and I'm actually a little dazed. So
don't worry, Barry. There's going to be a new normal. Don't worry, you'll have fun with your stuff as well.
All right, thank you. My stuff.
Well, we have to all be optimistic about this. Okay, we have to believe that there will be, the new normal will include both. That there'll be some version of theaters, because we can't live without theaters. I mean, that's not a future I'm willing to contemplate.
But remember, Anu, we are also talking about like when theaters open, there's going to be no air conditioning. There's going to be like reduced seating and stuff like that. And I think right down the consumption chain, things like air conditioning have been taken for granted right now. Yeah. I mean, like that's one of the many. So to kind of, especially in a state like Tamil Nadu, which is very, very hot, like for 11 months of the year. So when you're telling people that we're going to let you into a theater, but there's not going to be any AC and stuff like that, things like that are also going to affect people. Yeah. Saying
that's a deal breaker almost.
Yeah.
No,
yeah,
but Buddy, I'm going to give you a good scenario to end this thing, actually. The biggest problem in theatrical release for regional cinema has been the excess supply of content. We produce close to 200 films in a year, right? So the problem in theater experience has been primarily because there's been oversupply. And this is going to be a scenario where if you remove 30-40% of that content going to theaters and then divert them into OTT, your experience, the demand for going and watching good cinema in theaters is going to increase. This is going to be win-win in the long run. We're talking in the short term, but I think in the long term, I think there's going to be demand for that kind of experience. It's not going to replace going to a restaurant and having food, right? That social occasion where you want to do this. So whatever may be the efficiency of the Swiggy delivery, right? But it cannot take away that experience of watching a film in a theater. So, but what is killing is too much supply right now. And this is going to ease the pressure on the thing. So you're going to have longer show timing for, you know, movies. So you're going to have bigger windows for films to work, give it more space to breathe and actually work with the audience. So this is going to be good in the long term. We just have to get through this year first, actually.
Okay. Well, we're gonna go with that, because that's a happy thing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Very optimistic. Yeah.
We have to believe. Yes. Thank you, Shashi. Thank you so much.
Thanks, guys. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us, guys. Thank you.